face it, I suck. I'm not this amazing professional detective as you like to see me as. I'm not prepared. I don't know what the heck I'm doing. I'm too much of a chicken to approach and take out those guys at the door. And even you yourself admitted that. I need you, Piper. Piper?
He probably wants to give us a hard time. Why wouldn't he want his treasure to remain lost?
We're thinking that since he was a writer and since the Sunnyside poem was an excerpt from one of his collections, that the number 78 must be a page or a number of a poem in one of those collections. Lucky enough, I know one of his collections lies in the Denmark Museum of History, just south, a couple of hours from here.
Hey, Cash. I'm sorry for what happened back there. For what I said. You're not a terrible fighter. You're nothing like that.
It's nothing.
No, really. You're deserving of more credit than I had given you back there. Without you, we could have never made it this far.
Thank you, Viola.
Thank you. You haven't received much credit in your life, have you?
Not recently, no. I used to be one of a kind once, if you can believe it. Me and my dad, we were inseparable before he died. We would solve the hardest mysteries, track down the toughest criminals. He was always by my side and I by his. I was only a colt back in those days. My dad always said that the only reason he dragged me along was to help me because he couldn't fit his fat legs into crevices or fit into tunnels. Skinny as a bull, that kid is, he'd say. He'd make fun of me like that.
How did he die?
No! He was sick.
Oh.
Don't go feeling bad for me, Viola. I've dealt with it for years and I can deal with it now.
You don't always have to be the tough guy. It's okay to cry too sometimes. It doesn't mean you're weak. It shows that you care. And I wanted to thank you again.
Hey, it's nothing, really. I'll be glad to always fight for what's right. Especially for those that I love.
Viola, I need to talk to you. I saw Rose. What? When? Where? Back at the warehouse. I passed by a room as I was being led away, and I saw her there. She must be working with West then. We'll have to take precautions. Who knows who she'll be after next? No, I don't think so, Viola. I don't think she's as harmful as she seems. How can you say that? She left a murdered stallion on our doorstep. Does that sound harmless to you? When I glanced at her and saw her face, I didn't see the expression as I might have expected to see. It wasn't one of evil, but of worry and innocence, as if she cared about what might happen to me. Yeah, right. I wouldn't be surprised if she was just worried that we outsmarted her. Our little team is way more qualified than hers. Will you just listen, Viola? I'm trying to tell you something important. Why can't you believe me? You want to know why I can't believe you? Because I'm scared. I can't take the risk of thinking that Rose isn't against us. Too much has happened. Someone was murdered, I was nearly kidnapped, and you were! I know I'm going to turn around one day and see another Rose lying on the ground, and it scares me. I'm sorry, Viola, but I think someone else is behind this, and I think it might be Cash. You're blaming Cash? He's done nothing but help us! What better way to get his hooves on the treasure than to get close to us? He is not a traitor! You don't know what he's been through! He's lost his father, and Piper and us are all that he has left. And I think he might have said he loved me. And I think I'm growing to love him too. Think about that, why don't you?
Cash isn't as bad as he seems. He's great once you get to know him. We haven't properly met. I'm Piper, Cash's sister.
Nice to meet you.
Give Cash a chance, will you? He's been through a lot.
I'm not necessarily against him. I just needed someone else to blame, I guess.
Hey, we can do this. I never back down from a fight, and I hope I can say the same for you.
Come on, it should be just over here.
Hey, Cash, see this. Bartholomew, the treasure-hunting voyager, but his book, it's missing.
That can't be right.
Is everything okay over here?
No. Is it possible to check out any of these books?
No.
You couldn't buy them either?
I'm sorry, sir, but these are historical artifacts. We don't offer purchases or borrowing.
How come this one's missing?
Missing? Oh, this collection was mysteriously stolen just recently. We haven't replaced this, hoping that we would find the book again one day.
You've got to be kidding. There aren't any copies anywhere.
I'm sorry, these are all original rare books. No copies have been made of them.
Great. Great.
It's okay, Cash. It's okay.
So, I hear you're looking for something.
Who are you?
Names aren't important.
I'll ask you again. Who are you?
Sassy, aren't we? Those who know me call me Rowley. Those who don't call me thief, liar, cheat. The usual nicknames for a rascal like me. So, what do they call you?
Piper.
Not Miss Spoiled? Not Princess?
Excuse me? So what do you know about the book?
I know that I have it.
You stole it? How?
Snatched it off when they were doing a repair or something. Don't ask for all the juicy details. I can't give away all my secrets.
Why would you want it? What's it to you?
Can I say, I'm a fan of the guy. I'm a bit of a book addict.
So in other words, you're a geek.
No, I'm not a geek. I just happen to be very knowledgeable and enjoy reading.
All right. Well, hand over the book.
You think it's that easy? Funny. You want your book? You'll have to do me a favor. See that old man over there? Bow tie, top hat? He's nice, isn't he?
Yeah.
No, he's not nice. They call him Mr. Blaxley. Lives in a crystal clear mansion all by himself. Everyone's afraid of him. Why have a mansion all to yourself? Why always have it locked up with curtains draped and the lights off? Are you hiding something, Mr. Blaxley? He'll give you a stare if you even glance at him. Should be getting one right about now. Scared? He has that effect on people.
No, just get to the point.
Well, you see, he's got a book I need.
You really are desperate.
So, what do you say?
I say, bring it.